job creation programs would you introduce, or what recommendations would you make to improve current job issues?
Well, you know, at every debate, I discuss this job issue, because this job question comes up at every debate for the last 15 years, or probably 20 years, that I've been a citizen member, and like, it doesn't seem to change. The council of Riverside has built a warehouse, and we talk about tech jobs, they talk about tech jobs, almost until, where are they? It's just lip service, because what we have is warehousing. We have a huge economic development department, and hopefully they will be able to point us in the right direction.
Thank you. Nancy?
Job creation. We do need jobs in our city, and we need to train our residents here for jobs that are currently in our city. We don't want to train folks for jobs and have them drive to other places to go work. We need to keep our students here. I think we have a great system in our four colleges and universities here in Manhattan. Riverside City College, 100 years old this year, provides great technical careers in nursing, in welding, in computers, in many, many items where you can find a job here locally. I would say that the office of the mayor, too, doesn't have a direct connect to job creation, but we advise the council on these issues, and certainly have to be close to that.
Thank you. Question?
Patrick, where for the last 3 years, we created 10,000 jobs in the Bureau of Labor Statistics in 2014, 4,000 jobs alone. So we do have a job creation engine because of the investment that we've made. See, Nancy Park, the council, former councilwoman, helped with the Renaissance that attracted the attention of Riverside and brought investment and expansion for businesses that are already here. The strategy, though, most important, is to retain the businesses we have, to expand those businesses, because they can much more easily invest and reinvest in their business to create jobs than somebody from the outside coming in and us attracting them and building and then creating jobs. We're doing that with California Resources Board. They're generating 400 high-tech jobs for Riverside, $350 million invested. It's not going to be until 2020, 2021. So we need to continue, and I do this every month, or sometimes every week, about visit businesses, to see what they need to help their bottom line, whether it's through the public utility, economic development rates, or otherwise.
Well, first of all, I think very compliment from the mayor just telling me that I did a great job creating all those jobs for my colleagues. And I can assure you there, he can't even name 40 that he personally created or personally involved in. I can attest to that.
That's true.
Creation of jobs and introduction to an initiative is all about a lot of sitting up here talking. This is how you do it. First, you got to lower the bureaucracy and business of the planning department, which we're doing now, because it's extraordinary. It's not about the business world, but they know that we as City Riverside are very tough to business. We are changing that philosophy. We are changing our programs. We're changing how we do business. Second is, I have a small business job in Riverside, is what it's called. We're working on this right now. The first $1 million, a brand new building, a gross million. There are no fees for your first year. You have to do an actual change of our specific plans, or you've got to do a general plan to change your use plan. Second year, fees will be only 50% of the cost in the third year's full board. You've got to give entrepreneurship a chance to get off their feet. If you just nail them up front, most of them don't understand how to do the business and they will fail.
Thank you.